So it's always difficult to predict with any certainty what's going to happen in the markets on a forward basis. But in terms of what's happened year to date, the United Arab Emirates has generated the most amount of returns so far. In terms of our positioning of the fund, we're overweight to Saudi Arabia, so we think that's a market that will generate strong returns over the medium to long term. The UAE, of course, is seen as a regional safe haven, so it has generated good returns. In that market, for example, occupancy rates are up to over 80%. The real estate sector is doing particularly well as well, so that market should continue to do well. Pakistan, obviously, with the recent political results there, we think will be potentially a game changer for that market. And again, we're positioned to take exposure to reap the benefits of that in the future. What we would say is for people who understand the emerging market story would be to add to their exposure in terms of frontier markets. So there are something like 21 countries in the emerging markets index and another 30 countries outside in terms of frontier markets. So if you add to your exposure, you'll get the next wave of emerging markets through investing in frontier markets. At the moment, so our largest overweight is to Saudi Arabia. So there's a number of something like 1.5 million houses being formed in that market, and that will sort of lead a consumer story. So there's an opportunity there for companies focused on big box retailers, fiber into the homes, mobile broadband, so telecoms, and some of the retailers, for example. Sure. So in terms of the frontier markets benchmark, there is a very large weighting towards the financials. And these are very sort of simplistic banks that are simply taking in deposits at low interest rates and lending it out at higher interest rates. So from our point of view, if we like the country, then we generally like the banking sector. So that is an opportunity set. We do like to play the consumer story as well. So certainly, there are brewers in these markets that we like. There's many different telecoms that are playing into the consumer story. So there's lots of opportunity in that space. Of course, we have to be mindful of valuations. So the consumer discretionary and consumer staples have done very well and are currently quite expensive. We have increased our weightings prior to the elections in Pakistan. So we've had our team's been out in that market. They spent a week looking at many different companies. It's a very deep market in terms of sector exposure. There's very good companies, very good quality management teams, good levels of disclosure. And prior to the elections, we did increase our weighting, and post the elections, we've done the same as well. It's both wholesale and institutional investors. So really what we would say is anyone who understands the emerging market stories should consider investing in frontier markets. The portfolio is doing very well this year. It's up 20% in absolute terms, outperforming the industry standard benchmark by quite a margin. So doing very well. And in fact, last year we generated 25% as well. Yeah, so I mean, a number of companies are obviously to generate that sort of performance, but one company is Nagacorp, a casino operator in Phnom Penh. This is a company that we invested in about 3 years ago. No one knew the company. It wasn't well known by the sell side community. And over time, that company's been re-rated, and last year generated about 150%. So it's done particularly well, and that's what we like to do, is to go out, look for opportunities, look outside the benchmark, and explore opportunities and to make money as these companies get rated by the sell side community.